Rihanna is following in the footsteps of her mom on the runway, starting in her early teens, just like Teta.
Me and my mom definitely had like a really good relationship. Like I can tell her like anything, and I know that she won't like speculate or judge, because I know that she's been there and I know she's gone through those things. So, and we definitely got closer over the last 2 or 3 years, especially since I started getting interested in fashion, and she takes me out, and so. I think in a way she was trying to teach me how to act around grown-ups, how to act when you grow older. Yeah. And I think definitely because of that, I'm the person I am now. Mm-hmm. So if it wasn't for the relationship I have with my mom, I don't think I'd be who I am right now.
Rihanna inherited more than just her mother's looks, but also her indomitable spirit.
Get the best out of it.
You're really a chip off the old block.
I think I got that fighting spirit from her.
Yeah. When I realized the yung bigat nung situation, alam mo, super blessed ang feeling ko. What 15-year-old daughter be the rock of the family. So for that, I will be very grateful. Alam na nga natin na may sakit ka, 'di ba? Hindi naman lahat ng ano talaga positive. It's not all positive for me, di ba? Kasi syempre, pag nagkikimo ka. But then, hindi ko na iniisip yun. Sis, ang iniisip ko na lang is all the other good things that are going on in my life. My daughter, my son, my husband, full support, you know? My daughter said they were supposed to go to Tokyo for the summer. She said, I'm not going to leave mama. I'm going to stay with mama and I'm going to go to her first chemo with her.
And it kind of like puts everything into perspective on what's important in life. Like, if you don't have it, you don't exactly know. Mm-hmm. Until you finally get it, then you start to value how life is really, really important, because you don't know when your last day is ever going to be.
12-year-old Sebi is the man of the house, with Giorgio spending most of his time abroad, having returned to Japan in 2006 to reestablish his catering business and put up a branch of Piadina in Tokyo.
She doesn't even seem like she has cancer whatsoever. She's like the happiest person you'll ever meet. And like every single day I pray to God, if you take her away, that's the biggest mistake you'll ever make in your whole entire lifetime. I keep on praying that to him. Mm-hmm. But you know, it's life, and you know, she's here right now, so that's what's important.
Like many marriages, Teta and Giorgio had their problems. Giorgio's move to Japan came when the couple threshed out their issues.
There was an instance where it was either make it or break it. Parang, are we together or are we not together? And it was just really about the two of us coming to grip with our situation, our emotions, our plans, you know, our... Yung ganon, no? So when we got all of that, you know, in place, parang same wavelength na kami. And then, syempre, nag-adjust din kami ng mga expectations,
so
ganon.
You've been to the...
Yes, absolutely. Nung natapos na yon, the move to Japan came so easily.
You've been through the worst,
yes,
I suppose,
yes,
in your relationship.
After all, God said, now is time, because I know that even if you're apart, you know, you will always be together.
It was an ideal setup. Giorgio was achieving his dreams and providing for his family, with Teta looking after their brood in Manila, until cancer got in the way.
But then now I've cancer, diba? So ito ba yung next naman na now we have to be together again. So sa amin, parang this was probably, I don't want to say why I got cancer.
So it was near perfect actually.
Yes. Here, parang should we stay, should we go? Are we together, do we have to be together in one country or do we keep doing what we're doing now? So now, I think we have to be together. How that's going to happen, when that's going to happen, where we will eventually be together as a family, at this point, only God knows. But that's my everyday prayer. Now, after you know, I'm cancer-free, you know, when my treatment is over, you know, just bring us to that point of our lives that we can be together as a family. I knew that my life had already changed. My focus was my family and our business.
Giorgio's anxiety over his wife's illness has turned into awe, over the courage Teta has shown and the inspiration she is giving others in confronting cancer.
I just realized, you know, it's not that in that moment, you know, I had the confirmation that the woman I married, it was the right one, you know, because
that you made the right choice.
Right choice after almost 19 years. So you know, thank God to cancer also. So that also was another side that I never, you know, I imagine my wife had it, but I never see it. And strange to say, it is so beautiful to see a person in full power. Unbelievable. And the thing is, you know, again, courage is not something that, you know, you'll be born with. It's something you exercise every day. And the most important, you know, the meaning of courage is not to keep it, also to give. When I go in my restaurant in Manila, you know, people stop, oh, thank you, we were this, you know, and like this, so, oh, we went, and somebody, because, you know, I mean, I have to tell you something. The first time I discovered cancer, I thought I killed somebody. Because you wanted to hide. You almost feel embarrassed. You don't want to show anybody. But it's nothing like that, you know. You cannot imagine how you can help so many people.
Rihanna and Sebi will attest that the positive attitude is infectious.
Ito yung ginawa ko sa asawa. Gusto mo magpakasal sa Italy? Bahala ka lahat gumawa. Basta ako, sunbake lang ako ng sun.
It hasn't been so bad, actually. You know, I mean, besides that, you know, first few days, you know, we've just been, you know, looking at it as like, you know, a sickness, like, you know, cough or cold. And it's just a really long one. It's, you know, if you do things right and you take the right path, then, you know, it's just going to disappear.
It's actually still really hard right now to actually believe she has cancer because she still goes to the gym, she still goes out, she still, like, she can, like, go through life daily, like, with a smile on her face. And it's just, like, it's hard to believe. And it's just, like, sometimes moments, like, late at night, sometimes I just actually realize that she does have cancer. But I don't think any of it, because I'm not, like, listening to the statistics or anything. I'm just, like, focusing on she's going to be all right. I don't think I could have handled it with that much grace.
Words can't describe, you know. I just love my mom, you know. Can't take that away from me.
The down moments were really just when the first few days. But after that, she kind of like got into this mindset where I'm going to get through this. I'm going to be able to conquer this. It's like amazing to see.
Best medicine, as I say, is love.
No. She's going to overdose on that.
I'll physically die, but mentally die because of the overdose of all our love.
You did say bald is the new sexy.
Well, of course. It just, you know, when you have hair, it just cuts from your body. It doesn't, you know, curve and blend as well as if you were bald.
So she's more beautiful now than ever.
Sure, she was always beautiful, you know.
I always believe that we were, you know, two people in one body, and that it really is like that. I can understand the meaning of that word, that, you know, two people can become two, you know, one body. And that is something that, you know, again, thanks to cancer, we find out. And it's so great. Of course, I miss them badly, but somehow that things have brought us together, even when we are so, you know, apart. I learn how to put into practice to be positive, because you do not born positive. You have to exercise every day, you know, to be positive. So, and that's what we are I'm doing, and as person, as a family, and even our children, and I'm so happy, very, very happy.
For Teta, confronting her mortality has been liberating, not just for her, but for her loved ones as well. There is no doubt, like in all the other endeavors in her life, she will prevail once more.
Ito ba yung destinong binigay sa akin ng Diyos? If it is, I'll take it as it comes along.
After all of these things, I still have a recurrence or whatever. At least I look back to this time in my life. Every day, I live it fully.
Beautiful inside and out. Teta has never been more stunning. She's showing other women that living a full, happy, and productive life does not have to end with cancer. I'm Cez Oreña Drilon, and this is People on ANC. Thank you.